Last year on social media, we posted out an image of a 13 amp socket which we'd cunningly placed some Wago 221s on the back of to somehow suggest this was the direction that wiring accessories might head. So Gary, what was the feedback like on that?
Mixed and a little bit controversial. So we put it into the cupboard about 12 months ago. You've now brought it back out. What's your thinking behind that?
Well, recently on the channel, we've been looking at a lot of products that have screwless connectors in them, such as the JCC Skypack QR. What was the feedback like on that, Gary?
It was fantastic. Quick to install, easy to remove the conductors, and saved electricians time. And you know we like that at eFIXX.
So the question we're posing today is, when will we see screwless terminals on the back of wiring accessories?
Well, you've given me a socket outlet here that I think was purchased from one of those companies that are springing up all over the place and offer you a click and collect service. And believe it or not, this cost slightly less than the two donuts we've already eaten.
Yeah, they are delicious. Perhaps that's first part of the problem, Gary, is price, because these three Wago connectors I have here probably cost the same as one of the donuts in the box. And it's the question of, will people pay that extra to have the time-saving feature?
Okay, so that's one argument. The other argument's got to be the conductors that can go into the back of the socket outlet. So I could probably get 2 4mm squared cables in comfortably because it fits an A2 radial circuit specifications.
Okay, now I suspect there's something buried in BS 1363, I'm sure everyone has a copy of it, that prevents us from having screwless terminals. So perhaps we're putting that out there to people in the industry who make sockets to come back at us and tell us the reason we can't have them.
You've probably got ahead of the storm. So I can see you've attached a three and a three to accommodate your connections. Any feedback on that?
The feedback we had was obviously an additional terminal for the CPC, just so you could put that controversial lead to the back box.
Okay, so we're talking that your socket outlet in concept will accommodate the cables of a standard 13 amp socket outlet with your one, but as I look over at your cables being stripped here and my cables being stripped here, I've got a funny feeling you're luring me into a race, Gordon.
Well, I have, Gary, because another video I'm making, I've had to explore the world of German electrical accessories, and on another online retailer that offers free next day delivery, I found a product from Jung, which incidentally is the circuit breaker popping out noise you get when you work with Gary a lot of the time, but this one has screwless terminals already.
Right, okay. And is that from Germany as well as these Wago connectors?
It certainly is. So Germans ahead of us, ahead of the game, already doing it, so I thought we'd best take a closer look.
I'm not convinced this is a level playing field, so I'm going to open up mine just so I haven't
got
to do
again.
That. Yeah, yours is all ready to go, I see. Right, so terminated ends, so I've got doubled over ends, you've got singled ends, I see there. Is that what yours requires?
That's what it requires. They're all stripped to the length, a handy little length indicator on the front of this metal panel. Notice the surround is missing from the socket. That's a separate accessory you buy in Germany.
But the race is all about, can we get the cables in the back of it and terminate them? Because we're going to see if this one saves electricians time or the standard socket outlet.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. So my ends are ready to go, your ends are ready to go, so it's just a case of, I suppose you don't need a tool, do you?
I've got to take the screw out the front cover. There
is okay.
Slightly different concept here.
Right, okay, let's just give me
hold
a second.
Get out.
Well, I've just got to check. Yeah, yeah.
You're not allowed to back them out.
They're not,
this is a quality socket you're dealing with here. They're not backed out.
Yeah, of course they're not. Okay, so we do ready, steady, and then we go. Okay, right, go. Okay, so neutral first.
Undo the screw from this while Gary's messing around with that. He's backing out his screws. You'll notice in here there's just these little push terminals, so I just push that down. So
I'll be pushing mine in a minute.
Line conductor. So that one goes nicely in there. Let's put the CPC in there. Let's put the neutral connection in there. And then repeat for the second conductor.
Right, I'm nearly done.
Yeah, he's nearly done.
I usually win these races, I'll rapid gas.
And Earth's leaving slipped off there. Oh no, that wouldn't happen in Germany, they don't have it. They don't have it. So
come on. Really? Back that one off enough.
And there we go. That's comfortably done there. So while Gary's messing with that, I'll have one of these donuts. Mmm, they look delicious, Gary. You like donuts?
Yeah, I love donuts.
Mmm. Delicious. How are you doing there?
Well, the screw head keeps slipping out. Okay, so that's the line.
Yep.
I've got time to split my CPCs. Do a nice job there.
So this is delicious.
Yeah, I bet it is.
Oh, I haven't put the front cover back in there.
Okay.
I've put my donut down.
I think the race was to prove the connections are quicker, which I think you probably can comfortably say you
just
did.
Come back on there, a little screw in the middle there. Mmm, lovely.
Okay.
How's it going, Gary?
Yeah, Okay. All done. Okay. But again, from my point of view, I've done that to the tightness that I require personally, and we know, don't we, how we talk about torque settings in consumer units and distribution boards. Actually, by using a levered connection, the torque's already been set, so we can suggest the same there, that that's gone in and that's at the required terminating torque of pushed in connection. So that's could be the future, couldn't it? Is the Wago 221s or Wago, whatever you want to say, the future of the connections on the back of the 13 amp socket outlet?
I certainly think so. Just a case of who's going to be first.
And we like things that save electricians time, and we love your comments. So please make sure you make those comments below. Let's start the discussion. Is a connector of this style, push fit or otherwise, the way forward for the humble 13 amp socket outlet?